Well, just a week ago, the White House declared monkeypox a public health emergency. Now there are more than 10,000 confirmed cases in the U.S., 61 here in Minnesota. And yet guidance about who's at risk, how to get tested, and who's eligible for a vaccine has not been clear. That was a case for one Minneapolis woman who suspected she had the virus, but got the runaround when it came to confirming it. Charmaine Nero shares her story.
Julie, you may have seen her on TikTok. Joan Sullivan has gone viral for documenting her journey to get a diagnosis for what she believes is monkeypox, and it hasn't been easy. Minneapolis flight attendant Joan Sullivan is no stranger to taking precautions, but recently.
A little over a week ago, I hadn't been feeling well, and my partner is a flight paramedic. And I was telling her, I was like, I have not felt well like all week. And she was like, I know. And I was like, I swear, I do not know why I'm breaking out.
Thinking it may be monkeypox, she searched for answers online.
And so I was like, well, I'll just call my doctor's office. And they didn't have any appointments for me and told me to call the Department of Health. And then from there, called the clinics that the Department of Health recommended. They had me leave a voicemail so they could call me back.
Sullivan says she decided to quarantine on her own, and the following week, she was finally able to book an appointment and get tested through her healthcare provider. But she says the runaround didn't stop there.
At the time, told me that they needed the Department of Health's permission to run the test, which was frustrating of like, well, I already talked to them.
In July, the Minnesota Department of Health informed healthcare providers prior MDH approval for testing will no longer be required, although potential cases of monkeypox must still be reported. A spokesperson with Hennepin County Public Health tells Care 11 anyone who has lesions consisting of bumps, pimples, blisters can get tested at the Red Door Clinic. They went on to acknowledge that the clinic is very busy with high call volume, saying it is possible that some people are not getting through to us immediately, but everyone who calls does get a call back. While Sullivan is now awaiting her results, she is continuing to share her medical concerns on TikTok to help others spot the signs and symptoms.
Have that information so that they can know what to look for, and then they can self-advocate of like, it does look like monkeypox. I have looked into it. I have done the research. I need a test.
Now, a spokesperson with Hennepin County Public Health says they've added additional staff to increase phone triage capacity at the Red Door Clinic. They're urging those with monkeypox concerns to see their primary care providers if they develop a rash, symptoms, or were exposed. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Charmaine.